I made these solar heaters only to measure their energy parameters, and first I made this variant from a cheap polyethylene pipe. Then I measured the energy parameters of this second variant, which is characterized in that its pipes lie on a black surface. This is my third variant, which is similar to the first variant, but with large gaps between adjacent pipes. Then I tested this first variant, and we see large gaps between its pipes, like the third variant, but the pipes lie on a black surface, and its north side has thermal insulation. The main results of my test are described by these graphs and tables, which will be explained during this video. This is my measurement of the energy parameters of my four variants of the cheap solar heaters. However, I want to clarify that I use such cheap polyethylene pipe with an outer diameter of 16 mm and a wall thickness of almost 2 mm. The Ukrainian prices of this cheapest pipe are about 15 American cents per meter, and we can calculate that complete covering each square meter by this pipe is about $10. In addition, I painted my pipes, and now this half of the solar heater is already covered in black paint, which increases the efficiency of the heater and protects the plastic from ultraviolet solar radiation. So, a square meter of our solar heaters is about several times cheaper than these traditional pool heaters, but we can see that the energy parameters are noticeably better than our solar heaters. That is why our square meter will produce significantly less heat, and this is due to the fact that our black pipes do not cover the whole surface of the heaters. For example, the pipes cover only 66% of the surface of my second variant, because we see small gaps between adjacent pipes. In addition, these areas are not covered by the pipes, and I want to clarify that the coverage area is the multiplication of the pipe length by its outer diameter. The length of the pipes of my fourth variant is even 2 times smaller, and they cover only 33% of the surface of the heater. My first variant is covered with pipes by 73% if we think that this square is the area of the heater, and this is a fair idea if you remember how neighboring heaters are placed. The area of the third variant of my heater is covered with the pipes only by 37%. This table shows the heat production of 1 square meter of my 4 variants of the heaters during an absolutely sunny day in Europe, the United States and India. These are cases where the solar heaters must heat swimming pool water with a temperature of 30 degrees Celsius. It is interesting to compare our heat production with these more durable and expensive solar pool heaters. We see that 1 square meter of expensive heaters produces significantly more heat, but our square meter is several times cheaper. That is why our heaters can make economic sense if we do not have a deficit of space for the location of our solar heaters. In addition, we can remember that such heaters are sometimes used for a primitive shower. Now we see that the sun has heated the water inside the black pipes of my heater to 67 degrees Celsius, when the temperature of the ambient air was 28 degrees. This graph describes the heating capacity of 1 meter of my black pipe for my 4 variants, for this temperature difference between the heater water and ambient air. So, we see that our third variant is the most inefficient use of our black pipe. Now I show one of my experiments with the third variant, and this pump moves the water of this tank through our black pipe, which has already heated the water to 45 degrees Celsius. But on the other hand, our third variant is the best if the water temperature is noticeably less than the ambient temperature, and it can be a case of heating a pool immediately after replacing its water. Our first variant is similar to the third, but the gaps between the pipes are minimal. This experiment shows how my first variant heated 27 liters of water from a temperature of 22 degrees Celsius to a temperature of 52 degrees for 2 hours. We see that our first variant uses the pipes more efficiently than the third, because the large gap between the pipes of the third variant increases their heat exchange with the ambient air, especially during wind. Our second variant uses the black pipes even more efficiently than the first variant. This is because the pipes of the second variant lie on a black surface, which closes the path of loss of useful heat from the back of the pipes to the ambient air. Now this experiment shows how the second variant heated the water of my tank to a temperature of 58 degrees Celsius. We should pay attention to these small gaps between the pipes. I think that these small gaps slightly increase the efficiency of the heater, because they are black holes which catch solar radiation. Therefore, its energy almost cannot leave these black holes, and it turns into heat on the back of the pipes. So, we see that our first variant is the most effective use of the black pipes. However, the efficiencies of the first and second variants are approximately the same if the water temperature is high. This is my fourth variant, with large gaps between the pipes, which lie on a black surface. It is obvious that the basis of their efficiency is the absorption of the solar radiation which falls on the black walls of their pipes. In addition, this black sheet is also heated by solar radiation to a temperature of about 60 degrees Celsius, and this sheet of expanded polystyrene increases the heating temperature of the black sheet. Infrared radiation from the black sheet carries a bit of its heat to our black pipes, and this phenomenon slightly increases the efficiency of the fourth variant. In addition, the black sheets heat the air near the pipes, and it also slightly increases the efficiency. Moreover, we can remember the principles of operation of a traditional flat plate solar collector. I remind you that it also has a dark sheet and pipes, and solar radiation heats its sheet, and this heat is transferred to the pipes due to the thermal conductivity. It is obvious that the fourth variant also has similar thermal conductivity, but our thermal conductivity is very weak due to poor contact between our plastic pipes and the black sheet. I do not see economic sense of making that contact better, because it will increase the cost of the heater and its manufacture will be more complicated. My black sheet is a thin aluminum foil with a thickness of 15 microns. It is obvious that the efficiency of our heater will be slightly better if the foil is thicker, or if we replace it by a steel sheet with a thickness of several hundred microns. It is important to note that these were the results for perpendicular incidence of sunlight on the surface of the heater, and this situation will happen at noon. At the same time, the fourth variant will work well in the morning and evening, unlike the first and second variants. Our third variant will also work well in the morning and evening. In addition, I already tested these more advanced variants, which are covered with a glass sheet or cellular polycarbonate, and they have thick thermal insulation. These solar heaters are interesting for domestic hot water, and I will describe the results of their testing with one of my future videos.